Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Empires and Puzzles on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Empires and Puzzles and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Empires and Puzzles. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to start we need to launch our favorite browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type this URL, simply because there's a link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived here on the site of Usitility, at which we have a nice detailed overview on the way to obtain Empires and Puzzles on personal computer. We browse down a little bit and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on the link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to enjoy the game Empires and Puzzles on our PC. As you can discover from here, we have a number of advantages of running that emulator. Then, we will start downloading the Empires and Puzzles by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. The step is clicking on it. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the executable file. Okay, then we have to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the laptop or device. We have clicked yes. I reduce the browser to find the installation software considerably better. The installation software is straightforward. It contains a couple of possibilities: install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path actually does. We purely click it. Therefore we see that we end up with here the path where the emulator can be put in. If we want to change for better this folder we have got to click on that, browse, button, and we choose another directory and set up the emulator wherever we desire. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. And therefore I click on install. Great! The installation begins and it is going to go forward along with the download of these MB which are shown on this screen. When you save it on your hard drive, it could be a bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go faster or at a lower speed, based on your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator web servers. Today they are going rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been started successfully. As you will notice, down here, there's a progress bar which will fill up when it reaches the ending. The emulator can be started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been started, there for the very first time. Before we continue on, as you can see, it has made a couple of app icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be one we're considering. Whenever we want to operate Empires and Puzzles on the desktop or laptop, we double-click on this software icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should do the following step, which is actually a must-have, and which is to access the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is launched. Right here we are required to log on. Right now when we're on this page, we must absolutely perform the next phase that is imperative. So that we click on, Sign In. At this point it says, Checking Info. It could once in a while get stopped at Checking Info, and so it does not proceed. In that case, you can attempt to connect to your account after a number of hours and it may probably be corrected. At this point we are going to insert our email and password. The email must be a Gmail email as well as its matching password. As an example you may use the same email you are using currently in your YouTube account. Therefore I am going to enter my info and I will come back immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, data typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and presenting us their terms of service. We would consent to all of them by simply clicking on, I agree. After that, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You can also keep it selected and it will make a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you can utilize this option if you like. We click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched automatically and completely on its own. To set up the app, we need to get to the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking the icon marked in green. Currently that we are on the desktop of this emulator for Android, we can see that we come with here the install app option. We simply click on this button. At this point we have the game app. Let's then click right here on the install button that I'm just showing now in green color. This will start the software installation. Straight away it is going to install the Android game. It normally takes quite some time, or perhaps it could be very fast. It all relies upon on our own connection to the internet. It has already finished setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this particular option I'm showing in green, in order to use Empires and Puzzles for the first time. I am already on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are on the way to mouse click on this fresh Empires and Puzzles app icon that was provided. That game is started for the first time. Here we get it, I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume level of that emulator. This is right here, we have the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not count on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we will activate the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is the first one, we mouse click on that software icon that I am showing in green color. Then the screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. In the case that we want to have fun with the application using all the screen, we select this application icon. So we would at present be experiencing and enjoying the gameplay in 100% screen mode. To escape the 100% screen setting, hit the F11 key. And we'd now play in standard display mode. From now, I am going to demonstrate to you the computer keys mapping, and that is really very useful. That strategy we will probably be able to use the game much more effortlessly. The very first thing is to click on this keyboard icon. And right now there you will be able to get the recommended setups. Let me leave the normal settings, however if you really want to change it, you can achieve it without having problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is completely in our own language. Once in a while it occurs that your emulator is launched in the erroneous language, for instance, in Japanese. So to set it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. So here inside of many other configuration settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can determine the language we wish, Italian, Mandarin, etc. Once the language is chosen, we should save, the emulator will restart, along with the game, the next time we start it, would also be in the preferred language. At this time, there is another information that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google reporting that a completely new equipment has been connected to our Google account. It will ask us if we're the people who have connected that device. Yes, we ought not get worried, since the emulator is behaving like an Google Android smartphone or tablet. And then to see which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we visit right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. So we go here to the model choice. And now we learn that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for that video user demo. I hope that you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was informative. If that's so, give it a good like, subscribe, and if you have remarks, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment field below. You may also leave comments on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams on occasion, you get it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click any of the instructional videos which are usually appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the future instructional videos. Bye!